my loves. Welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Renee. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. Today I'm going to be opening up with my own personal story of coping with social anxiety, what it's like living through it, I mean experiencing it, and where it comes from for me, how I kind of figured out where it stems from, and how I've been able to implement practices in my life that have really helped change the way that I perceive my own anxiety, and I hope it will help you as well. Also, how I've successfully been able to finally change my narrative and step into the person that I've always wanted to be, a very confident and secure person in myself. So let's get into the video. So for almost my entire life, I've been labeled the quiet girl, the girl kind of just there, the girl that's really, you know, doesn't stand out, the girl that's not very confident, the girl that's never gonna be a leader. I've been labeled the girl that is delicate, that is sensitive. And it took me years and years to finally rip off that label and to tear it apart. And to this day, I am still constantly improving myself. I still get feelings of anxiety, of stress, of things that just don't go the way that I want them to. And I'm still improving myself. I am not perfect by any means, but that's okay with me now because I've learned to actually honor those feelings. And I know that sounds kind of absurd and like, why would you honor your anxiety? But just take a quick second and think about this with me. When we face these situations that bring us major heart palpitations, major stress or anything like that, and then we realize that we are having kind of these anxious thoughts, and then we continue to move forward regardless. I don't know about you guys, but I feel so relieved and so proud of myself for being able to conquer my fears and my anxiety in that situation. So what I mean by honor is like, understand that it's there and then punch it in the face. Like, be like, no, you're not gonna dictate my life. You're not gonna control me. My anxiety is not who I am. My anxiety tells me that I am growing, that I am evolving. And implementing that thought process has really helped me kind of just get over it and take its power away and instead put that power back in myself. So I am actually very soft-spoken in person. Like, my voice is literally soft-spoken, it doesn't carry well, and I always saw myself as this girl in the background who would like have to work extra hard in loud environments to be seen or to even be noticed, and I would just get lost in the crowd otherwise. And this has actually happened to me. Like, I've actually been part of those situations, so it's this belief system built on past memories that has been really hard for me to let go of. I would see myself not as a leader whatsoever, not somebody that could sit here in front of a camera and share my story with you guys, because it wasn't, you know, worth it. It wasn't something that was gonna be important or listened to or anything like that, when that's definitely not true. I've implemented so many successful practices that I want to share with you guys, but in order for you to understand the type of impact that it has had, you need to understand where I'm coming from. So when I was a really little girl, when I was like going through kindergarten and elementary school, I was a very, very, very shy person. I would literally cling to my mom's leg and run away from people whenever anybody would try to have conversation with me. And I have no idea why I was like that. But one thing about my family is that on my mom's side, she is from Czech Republic. And so she is multilingual, and different languages were spoken in my household when I was growing up. So I knew a little bit of English and I knew a little bit of Czech. And I used to actually combine languages into my sentences. So what I mean by that is, I would actually speak like one part English and two parts Czech in one sentence. And I think because I was so shy, I would do that as like this coping mechanism for like understanding that nobody was gonna get what I was saying or where I was coming from. And so they would like avoid talking to me, but it worked a little bit too well because I think the other kids, like, I didn't make friends very easily when I was little. And I think the other kids were scared of me because they thought I was like casting spells on them or something. And because of the way that I was very antisocial when I was growing up, I was actually put into a special ed class. And I think this kind of created this belief in me that being different was wrong, and that if I was introverted, that there was something wrong with me. And looking back on it, there's nothing wrong with being different at all. And it just kind of sucks that because I was different, I was put into a different environment because my teachers didn't understand and it wasn't treated the way that I think it should have been. And it created these belief systems that I'm not good enough, that I can't be where other people are. Okay, and with that belief system formed, fast forward to high school, and this is where I really started to understand that it was anxiety. Going through puberty alone is stressful enough, but when you have these underlying beliefs that corrupt your confidence and basically make you feel like you don't know if you can be yourself or who you even are, it just adds on to that kind of stress that I didn't need when I was going through my adolescence. And because I didn't have this strong sense of self, when I was in groups with like other girls or that sort of thing, I would actually start to take on their personalities versus my own because I never knew who I was. I never knew how I needed to act. I never got the proper exposure to being a social person. I never knew who I was because I thought being myself was wrong. I had absolutely no self-awareness and I struggled really badly with trying to listen to my inner guidance. It was almost like I didn't have an inner guidance. Like I never took the time to actually learn how to listen to it. Now, because I never knew who I was or what I wanted to do or who I needed to be in social situations, I didn't know how to act. I would start to get heart palpitations going into these conversations because I've dealt with feelings of awkwardness, of feelings of the girl that nobody ever wanted to be around. Now, even because I had a decent amount of friends in high school, and you would think, oh, she didn't feel alone, but in reality, I felt more isolated than I had ever felt. I felt like I was watching myself live my life outside of my own body. I never felt like I was a part of my life, if that makes sense. It was very disheartening growing up that way and very like hard on me as a teenage girl with all these hormones flowing in my body and being crazy to feel like I didn't have any sort of self-awareness or any kind of confidence, and my self-esteem was literally just, it wasn't even there. I felt so lost and confused throughout my adolescence that, I mean, it wasn't healthy for me. I wasn't reaching out and talking to anybody like I should have. Now, I'm not saying that my entire adolescence was bad. I'm not saying that at all. I had some really amazing times and I did have some really amazing friends that really tried to help me. It just was really difficult. And looking back at it, one thing that really helped me get through those situations was having deep conversations with my friends when they were struggling. I really was in this sort of flow state of mind whenever I was helping other people through their struggles. And I think it's because it would get my mind off of my own life and my own stress and anxiety and depression that this person's happiness would be the most important thing in that moment. And those were times that I felt most genuine and most true to myself was when I was helping other people through their problems. It always brought forth these feelings of purpose in my life, and that's why I'm creating these YouTube videos, is because it's just something that I truly and genuinely enjoy doing and where I feel most like myself. Fast forward to college and I joined a sorority, and I know what you're thinking. It's not like the movies whatsoever. The sorority I joined was full of empowering strong women that really helped me to start to actually find my own voice. They helped me get out of a very emotionally abusive relationship. And because I was surrounded by these amazing women that were just very uplifting, they helped me realize that I needed to find my voice again. This was the first real opportunity that I had to discover who I was and what I wanted to be. But with that came feelings of frustration and kind of feeling like I was behind everybody else. So I felt like I was always trying to catch up, and that broke me down a little bit too. I had been lost for so long in my life, I had no idea where to even start to find out who I was to my core. So during the first couple years of college, this is where I started to actually experience my anxiety attacks and where I started to experience my mental breakdowns. And it was because I had these feelings of failure, like I wasn't going to amount to anything, these feelings of being behind, these feelings of racking up debt for no reason because I had no idea who I was or what I wanted to do with my life. And it was a long, excruciating process, but when I started implementing practices towards the end of college and towards, you know, my early adult years, my 20s, that's when I started to actually feel more and more like myself and more confident in myself. And I'm finally to the point where I'm actually feeling like more and more in alignment with my higher self and my purpose. Now, like I said earlier, I am by no means perfect, and I still get into social situations that give me a lot of anxiety, but it's definitely more and more in control, and it's because of the following practices that I'm gonna share with you. Since this video is already pretty long, I'm only gonna go over three practices. Each person is so unique to what's gonna help them that you might resonate with one of these tips, but maybe there will be more that you resonate with in my next video where I'm gonna go into more details and have more of the practices that I've tried and implemented in my life that have helped me. Subscribe and hit that notification bell if you want to see that video come out. So one of the first practices that I've implemented into my daily routine is exposing myself to more situations that bring me anxiety. And I know that sounds very scary, and I know that sounds a little bit chaotic, but trust me, to conquer your fears and your stressors, you need to actually expose yourself to these situations so that you can punch them in the face, so that you can start to improve yourself and to evolve. So start small and grow as you feel more and more comfortable. And it could be as small as posting in a Facebook group to as big as driving into a city to meet up with a friend all by yourself at night, which is a real thing that I've done, and it terrified me, but because I did it, I feel so much more comfortable moving into the next situation that calls for me doing that same action. Number two is that I started questioning my feelings of anxiety. Most of the time we get these anxious feelings because we are playing out the scenario in our head, we're visualizing it, and we are coming up with the worst possible outcome. When in reality, it's just an exaggerated thought, and it's actually so far from the truth and what's real. So I started actually questioning these thoughts like, oh, is everybody actually staring at me? Oh, is everybody not able to hear me? Is this 100% what is happening right now? And then dissecting them and realizing that it was far from the truth, that there was nothing to be anxious about, that everything's actually okay. And my third and final tip for this video is being around high vibe people and opening up. So when I started to actually talk to my sorority sisters, when I started to talk to my mom and started to talk to my friend and being vulnerable, that's when I really started to see so much weight lifted off my shoulders and feelings of this just relief, like all over my body, mind, body, and soul, just relief. Being vulnerable can be scary, and I was definitely one person to run away from it, but when you actually start to embrace it, that's when you notice a big shift in your reality. I was also very motivated to change my narrative and stop letting anxiety have any kind of power over me. When I started seeking out help and having these deep conversations, that's when I started to feel peace in my heart. And that's when also I started to stop viewing anxiety as this thing that you should be ashamed of and something that should be talked about, that, you know, you should seek out help for. Okay, so that's the end of my story time and my tips for coping with social anxiety. If you found value here, please give this video a big thumbs up. It really does support my channel, and it lets me know that you guys are here listening. I will be filming another video about different practices that I have implemented in my routine and going into a little bit more detail. So hit that subscribe button and notification bell if you want to be notified when that video does come out. I love you all so, so, so much. Just know that you are perfect the way you are, and to not be ashamed of talking about mental health, because it's not shameful, and 15 million other Americans in the United States do have these feelings of social anxiety. It's not something to be ashamed of. It's very normal. It's part of being human. It's the human condition. So let's just talk about it. Let's all be here for each other, and let's make the most out of this life.